We got all kinds of bikes here now. These guys just came in from the dumpster. They said they were all up in the mud.
Wow.
They're wearing half the dumpster on them, you know, so. Anyhow, probably a good thing we didn't go today. But yeah, we're just kind of people watching and checking things out here. Getting pretty wet and muddy, so you can see how soupy the roads get. That's what we're trying to avoid if we can, carrying half the road on our bikes. All right, the ferry line was so full, we decided to come up to Dome Road. This is a little ride that our friends told us about that overlooks Dawson City, so we thought it'd be fun to come up and check it out. Hopefully we don't get rained on too bad. It's been pretty rainy today, but it's all paved, pretty easy run. So we're just gonna cruise up here and check it out. It's not very far, but it's supposed to give you a pretty cool view of Dawson City, overlooks the valley. It's 6:44 in the PM. It's August 1st, 2022. Had actually a pretty full day today, had a lot of fun, very relaxing. Now, I wouldn't be surprised if we may run into some wildlife up here, huh? Oh my goodness. Oh yeah, this is cool. Whoa, that's gonna be a picture right there. Oh my gosh, dude. That is a freaking sick picture. All right, we are at the Midnight Dome above Dawson City. Let you guys see this view. Wow. Okay, there's the Yukon River. Pretty gorgeous. Quite spectacular, the view up here. When you see that? When you say it's a spectacular view.
Spectacular.
Yeah.
You see where the Klondike meets the Yukon?
Yeah.
The black and the brown?
Yeah. It blends in right there. Klondike's coming in right there, meeting the Yukon and the different temps. And you can see this is the Klondike right here. So it's pretty crazy. Pretty awesome.
It's 11:44, almost midnight. This is what Dawson City looks like in the evening. A lot of bikes. Anyhow, getting ready to brush my teeth and go to bed because we got a long day ahead of us tomorrow. Probably a little bit of rain riding, so I want to get to sleep. But anyhow, today was a great day. Had a lot of fun. End of day 18. It's in the rear view. So we'll see what day 19 brings us. That's all for now.
It is August 3rd. I think it's day 19, and we're waiting for the ferry to come back over to shuttle us over. I'm with my Canadian friends, so don't hold it against me.
From what I understand, yours is really small and skinny. Apparently, yeah.
But we're just waiting for the ferry, getting ready for day 19. Anyhow, but yeah, we're looking forward to a good trip. There's the free ferry that takes you across the Yukon over to the other side. It's gonna be awesome. What are we, boys?
Well, we act like
we're just men in a cave causing mayhem. Come on, let's say it.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Ready?
Yep. We're just a marvel at the way that the U.S. built those highways. It's incredible. Yes, we can't thank you enough.
Man, these damn Canadians. What am I gonna do with them?
All right, we're just waiting on the ferry to come in. This is a Yukon crossing right here where we're going over so we can head towards Chicken, Alaska, and that'll be the first time we've set foot in American soil in how many days, Brandon? I don't know, it's been a while. So we're gonna jump back on American soil for a couple days and then we're heading back into Canada. Then we'll be in Canada probably for another week before we head home. But I'll tell you what, if you guys do one of these trips, make sure you bring everything but the kitchen sink as far as preparations for bike repairs, because we learned our lesson the hard way. we thought, we'll bring an extra tire just in case, an extra tube, bring two extra tubes, bring what you need. Yeah, that fit, tubes that actually fit. I mean, the 21-inch tube worked out great for in a pinch for the rear 17 tire, but man, lesson learned, I'll tell you that. But yeah, and if you extra tools, you know, extra everything, because you end up getting in a situation where you need something and you don't have it, and it takes weeks for them to get it or days for them to get something out to you. So anyhow, I just wanted you guys to see the ferry loading up. We're going to go on to the ferry, and I'll talk to you then. All right, guys, we're on the ferry. And this is the Yukon. What a beautiful sight, huh? Don't get to do this every day, do you? Probably a once-in-a-lifetime trip for me. But super cool. Right up there is where the Yukon and the Klondike merge together, the two rivers. And there's Dawson City. Wave goodbye to Dawson City. Oh yep. Yeah. You can see the water swimming over the bow of the boat here. There's the Canadians over there handling business. Yep. Yukon flag, Canadian flag over there. We'll soon be back in our country. Cool. Pretty cool how this sits along the river. You can almost picture what it was like in the 1800s. All right, we're running up the top of the World Highway, heading towards Chicken, Alaska. Woo! Beautiful day today. We got some sunshine, which we were waiting for. Trying to avoid that nasty rain. We should be hitting some dirt here soon. Oh yeah. Yep, we're hitting dirt right away here. We got Robin up front, and then David. Robin's rolling on his Harley. David's on the Tiger 1200, and they're ripping. So we're having a good time running up this road. Just have to watch for RVs. I guess it gets a little hairpinny up some of these roads, and they say to kind of keep your eye out for RVs and stuff. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna just kind of take it easy and enjoy the ride. Yep. Thank you, sir, for the pothole watching. I guess my son is watching out for me, pointing out the potholes. Yeah, hosers, we are at the top of the world, boys and girls. Wow. Of course, Robin's on his Harley. He's not able to stand and really see the view that we're seeing, but man, what a view.
Nice day.
Beautiful. Yeah, great call on that.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to listen to my Canadian friends more often.
Well, you know how to ride your road.
Look at that. Wow. Oh my goodness. Oh, we got some potholes. Anyhow, if you haven't yet, don't forget to like, share, subscribe. Hit that bell for notifications. Check us out at Instagram at mancave_mayhem. More views, guys. More views. Top of the World Highway. Day 19. My goodness, it is just hard to believe. If you guys ever get an opportunity to check this out, it's worth doing. Still rolling, gorgeous view. Dirt road is pretty doable, it's very nice. More views, riding with our Canadian boys. Do not regret putting that day off. Look at this. Oh my goodness. Amazing. Who would have thought? Who would have ever thought? I'm speechless. I just can't believe what I'm seeing here. It's amazing. If you ever get a chance to do this, you gotta do it.
Running around 60 miles an hour, the dirt road's pretty nice. A little loose gravel just to kind of watch out for, but that's about it right now. The road's very dry compared to what we heard yesterday. It was raining like crazy, so the road's pretty dried out. We're actually getting dust up here, so
which is kind of shocking. Oh my goodness, we are getting some wind and some weather, it looks like, up here at the top end, about 65 miles on this highway here, and we still got a ways to go. We're heading towards the United States border, and just to give you guys an idea, we're starting to get a little bit of rain, it looks like. Hopefully it doesn't get too soupy or messy, but yeah, the road's a little mucky. Not bad though. I feel like I'm in Ireland. It's magically delicious. Yes. So yeah, there's some snow there. 52 degrees. It's not terrible, but it's not the warmest either. Thank the Lord above for heated seats and heated grips. Yeah, look at the valley. Wow, beautiful country. Beautiful country. Oh, this is cool. I don't know about these Canadian guys.
If you can see on the helmet, Poker Creek, Alaska. Mostly northern land, border port in USA. I don't know if you guys can see that or not. I still got my camera going. Pretty cool. Pretty cool to see. Got the Canadians in our way. They're trying to block the American flag there.
USA! USA! Thanks a lot, man. Hey, now this is maintained. 43 miles of chicken. Then they have eagle. Yeah, baby, we made it. Made it to Alaska, finally. Oh, I almost dumped my bike. Our Canadian friend's over there taking a leak behind the Alaska sign, nonetheless. It's kind of disrespectful taking a leak behind the Alaska sign. I'm gonna tell them at the border about that.
Get to Alaska, boys and girls. Woo! Yeah. They even let the Canadians in. But look at this view. Wow. It's a little, yeah, it's a little bit chilly, but man, what do you think, B-Man?
Pretty fantastic.
Pretty fantastic.
What a view, what a view. All right, looks like we're coming into Chicken, Alaska. Population, I don't know. Who knows? Not many. Another part of the journey that we wanted to do, and we're doing it. We are in Chicken, baby, and they got food.
Chicken's called Chicken because they wanted to call it ptarmigan. They didn't know how to spell it.
Wow, baby. Let's go in the bar and see if we can pay for something here. Okay, this is interesting. Wow. This is the bar
I don't know where anybody is though right now. Chicken Creek Cafe is open. Let's see if anybody's here and we can pay for some stuff. Oh, thank you.
After you.
This is where it's happening, right?
That's right. Chow time.
Chow time.
Alaska, baby. Alaska.
I know that there's enough room for the pie, so.
True enough.
Is that how they do it in Canada? Dessert first?
Do whatever you want. Isn't any
rule? Heck no. Is the pie. This place is awesome. Brandon got chicken burger. Oh, it's all ground up, huh?
No.
This is good. Salmon burger here. Oh my gosh, taste that. Take a little taste.
Pretty good stuff. I recommend it highly.
Crazy good. Crazy, crazy good.
So we couldn't decide.
I turned around and Brandon ate all my food. Look at now he's working on his. Freaking piggy boy. Just irritates me. I never get to eat. There we go. Another one under our belts, right, B?
Yep.
Oh, in Chicken, Alaska. Oh, we've struck it rich. Just remember, I'm just a man in a cave causing mayhem. Thanks for watching, folks.